We have seen in our household the natural quality of the water is it flows from higher level to lower level. So we put an overhead tank on the roof and we have a tap, and below that tap there is a sink. The water comes out naturally from higher to lower level. This is a sort of natural process or a natural engine working by the force of gravity, working by potential energy. Okay. So that is a natural one. But that tank has to be filled up, and for that purpose we want that water should flow from lower to higher level. It refused to flow because the natural direction is higher level to lower level. Why it should go from lower level to higher level? But we insist and we do it. How we do it? We are putting a pump. That pump is doing certain work. So the lower potential energy of the water is mixed up with the work by the pump and it is risen to high level. That is reverse action, reverse engine. The same thing we have in the heat engine, we call it reverse heat engine. That is heat pump. And this heat pump, practical example is refrigerator. Inside the refrigerator, how is the temperature? Low. We put a milk in that low temperature and outside is higher temperature of the air. But what's happening? We are taking out the heat from the low temperature of milk to convert it into ice cream. And that heat is rejected in the atmosphere, which is already at a higher temperature compared to refrigerator. So this is a reverse action. This is a reverse heat engine. So see here the scheme. This is our normal heat engine. From higher temperature T1, T higher, we take out the heat. Some of the heat is used in the work done by the substance and rest of the heat goes to the sink, which is at lower temperature. In the reverse heat engine, this is lower temperature sink and we take out heat from here. Here it was given, here we take out the heat Q2 from the sink and mix up with the work, with the pump, and then we send it to the source, to the atmosphere here. So this action is reversal of this action. Therefore, this is known as heat pump or reverse heat engine or refrigerator. So this is the schematic diagram how a refrigerator works. Right. So what do we do in a refrigerator practically? That I will also explain so that you can understand it very well. In the refrigerator, we have a cold chamber that is inside our refrigerator, cold chamber. It has lower temperature T2. Okay. Now, from here, we take the gas, which is the working substance, gas, freon gases, or any refrigerant we call it. This refrigerant is at a lower temperature T2, okay, or this is the atmospheric temperature. Let us say this temperature is T, atmosphere. Here the temperature T2, which is low, very low. This T2 low temperature cools up our milk, vegetable, other things, and by cooling them, this temperature a little one heated and it comes to the atmospheric temperature T. So the gas comes out at atmospheric temperature T. Okay. Now this gas, which is at temperature T, is passed through a pump. This pump we call as compressor. This compressor has appeared by the name compress, and there is a thermodynamic process. Whenever we compress, the volume decreases and it is adiabatic process. When it is compressed, suddenly the temperature rises. And the temperature rises to a very high temperature, and this temperature is now has become high temperature T1. T1, very high temperature. Okay. Now, this high temperature, this tube, it is atmosphere at what temperature? T. T1 is higher than T. So, what does it do? All these tubes radiate out heat. Heat is radiated out to what? To atmosphere. This atmosphere is at a higher temperature. Which is that higher temperature? T. I will again change the nomenclature so that we can have an identity with it. Let us say this atmosphere is at a temperature T1. And there is a compression here. This temperature, which is here, is more than T1. More than T1. So, which is higher temperature? Gas. The gas is at a temperature which is larger than T1. This atmospheric temperature T1 is 25 degree. This temperature T1 is 50 degree. Larger than T1, that is from the compression. So, if this is 50 degree inside, 25 degree outside, the gas is going, the heat is radiated out. The heat is radiated out from here to here to here and everywhere. By the time the gas comes here, this temperature becomes 40, 30, and finally, how much it is? It is 25. Why? It is radiating heat. Everywhere it is radiating heat. Have you seen in the refrigerator? You touch it on the back side, on the sides, that is heated up, that means heat is going out. So, the temperature which was 50 here, 50 after compression, when it comes here, it is 25 and it has lost energy. It has given energy to atmosphere. How much energy it has given to atmosphere? Q1. This is at 25. Okay, now it comes here. Here it is 25 and it enters the refrigerator. When it enters the refrigerator, here we fit our device, and that device is a valve or a capillary tube, which is a very small bore capillary. Now, when the gas comes here and it crosses it, suddenly after the capillary, we have a large bore here. I will make it here this way. See? From here, it is going this way. This is a small bore. And the moment it enters it, we fit it into a large pipe like this. This is the large pipe. This diameter is very large compared to this diameter. So, there is an expansion. Here is an expansion. Because of this expansion, the temperature decreases. This we have studied just now in adiabatic expansion. In the first law when we were studying adiabatic process. So, because of this expansion, the temperature goes very much down. From 25 degree, it jumps down, 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 and it becomes minus 10 degree. Minus 10. This temperature is less than T2. This is less than T2. So low temperature. Now, this minus 10 and this tube goes all over the refrigerator and it cools the complete body of our freezer here. And it is taking heat from milk, vegetable and all the other contents. When it is taking heat from here, it is absorbing heat. How much heat it absorb here? Let us say it is absorbing heat Q2. Q2 is the heat absorbed by it. Now, this Q2 it absorb, and because of this absorption, this temperature rise, and this temperature rise, and this becomes almost T1. By the time it comes out, it is how much? T1. Due to absorption of heat, this T1 is what? Atmospheric temperature. Atmosphere has a temperature T1. With this atmospheric temperature 25, it enters compressor, and the compressor compress it here with the piston. The moment it compress it, how much is the temperature? 50, which is larger than the atmosphere. This gas in the pipe has temperature 50, it gives out the heat here. The heat is lost from the working substance. Here it goes there. There is an expansion, this temperature comes down to minus 10, this is very cold, and now this temperature, lower temperature is T2. At this lower temperature, it absorbs the heat from refrigerator because it is very, very low. It absorbs heat from the refrigerator, gets heated up, come back to T1, 25, and comes out. Again, compress it 50. Now, let's fit it into engine parameters. Here, compressor is doing the work. What it is doing? Work. This work. Here, very low temperature T2, it is absorbing the heat. How much? Q2. So, it is absorbing the heat Q2 from the sink. It is taking out, and how much is the temperature? T2. T2 temperature, it absorbs the heat. Lower temperature, because this temperature is lower than T2, it is absorbing the heat here. And absorbing the heat comes out with a slightly high temperature, atmospheric temperature 25. Here. So, it is absorbing heat inside the refrigerator, and this is radiating heat in the atmosphere, which is at a high temperature. Absorbing heat at a lower temperature. Let us say refrigerator is at 0 degree. This gas coming at minus 10 is lower than 0, therefore it absorbs heat. So, in the refrigerator, it is absorbing, in the atmosphere, it is radiating. Why it is able to radiate here? Because our compressor increased the temperature to a very high temperature 50, which makes it radiate out. So, because of this work, because of this pump action, it becomes able to radiate out the heat. It is able to radiate out the heat to the reservoir, hot reservoir at T1. It is giving out the heat here, and it is absorbing heat here, and this is a reverse action. So, this is working of the refrigerator. Now, in the refrigerator, this is how it works, reverse engine. Do we have anything like efficiency? Yes. But we give it a different name. This is known as coefficient of performance. Coefficient of performance of refrigerator. How much work we have to do, W. With this work, how much heat is taken out? Q2. So, with 1 joule, how much heat is taken up? Q2 upon W. So, if our pump is doing 1 joule, for every 1 joule, how much heat is taken out? Q2 upon W. This is coefficient of performance. So, we have coefficient of performance here. Coefficient of performance is equal to Q2 upon W. This is heat absorbed divided by work done by the engine, work done by pump. Okay. This is coefficient of performance of refrigerator, and this We can give it any symbol, say alpha. So this is the performance showing. Now this Q2 upon W, how much is the work done? This work, initially the heat taken from here is Q2, here the heat pumped out is Q1. So how much is the work equal to? Q1 minus Q2, or we can say W plus Q2 is equal to Q1. W plus Q2 is equal to Q1. So W is equal to work done is equal to Q1 minus Q2. That we put here. So alpha is equal to Q2 upon Q1 minus Q2. If we convert them to temperature, MS T2 1, how much this will be? T2 upon T1 minus T2. This is performance, coefficient of performance. What is T2? T2 is temperature inside the refrigerator, T1 is temperature outside. Now you see, this performance will be less if we keep the refrigerator temperature lower. The same refrigerator will show a lower coefficient of performance if we increase its number and we ask it to work at a lower temperature. Similarly, when outside there is summer, T1 become very high. If T1 become high, the performance become less. It's unfortunate, when we need it to perform better, it works with a low performance because T1 has become very high, and this heat radiation has become weaker because this high. So 50 to 25, there will be certain flow of temperature. If this become 35, 50 to 35, this flow will become less, slow. So the heat radiated out is slow. That's why in summer its performance become less. So this is the performance coefficient, and this is the heat pump which act like this. So this is about the heat engine and reverse heat engine. How heat engine work? What is an ideal heat engine? We will find out how much work is done by making an ideal engine which was made by Carnot's. That is known as Carnot's engine, and every ideal engine is working on the principle of Carnot's engine. So in the next lecture we will see how Carnot's engine work and what is the principle of it, what is cycle of it. Thank you.